morning students. Today we are going to start the new chapter, that is pressure. So chapter number 12 is related to pressure. So already you have studied about the topic force and friction. So force is related to pressure, because if we apply force on a less area, then pressure will be more, and if we apply force on more area, then pressure will be less. So we say that force is related to pressure. So in this chapter you will study about the pressure. What is pressure? Number 2, the pressure exerted by fluids. Number 3, the pressure exerted by gases. Number 4, atmospheric pressure. And number 5, measuring atmospheric pressure. So come to the activity. Does air take up space? Yes, air has volume, it takes the space. So some activity is given. Make a small ball of small paper towel. So what we will do, we will take a small paper towel. What is paper towel? Paper towel is a sheet of soft, thick paper, made of paper, which is used in kitchen, in drying the liquid, and also cleaning the objects and absorbing the liquid. So we will take a small paper towel, crush it, and put it into an empty glass in such a way that paper towel does not fall. When we invert the glass, see here. Now fill a broad container. So we will take a container and fill the water in such a way that the depth of water should be equal to or greater than the height of the glass. Now we'll place the glass upside down into the water carefully without tilting to the side. And when you lift the glass from the water and remove the paper towel, you'll see that the paper towel is still dry. Why? Why this happen? So this happens due to the reason. Some reasons are there. Since air occupies the space, air has volume. So when we put the glass which has the crushed paper towel, we put the straight into the water, and since air is there, air traps on top of the glass. Since air is little dense than, less dense than water, dense, that means air has less density compared to the water. So air traps and occupies the part of the glass. So that's why the water does not go inside the glass and the paper towel does not become wet. So this proves that air has space. Yeah, air has volume, it occupies space. So we say that air occupies the space. And come to the topic pressure. So pressure, you have noticed that when we always hammer the head of the nail and pointed side is embedded on the wall, into the wall. But what will happen if we do the reverse? Will the nail go? If we hammer the pointed side and keep the flat side on the wall, will the nail go inside the wall? No. Why does this happen? This happens because the pointed side of the nail embed easily on the wall due to the physical quantity that is called pressure. So pressure is not simply force, rather pressure can be defined as the force spread over an area. This pressure is defined as the force spread over an area. Underline it. So mathematically, pressure is expressed as force / area. Say pressure means pressure is directly proportional to force. If force is more, then pressure may be force. But pressure is inversely proportional to area. So P is directly proportional to F, whereas P is inversely proportional to area. If area is more, pressure is less. If area is less, pressure. P is equal to F/A. So large area, low pressure. Small area, high pressure. So that means pressure is related to area as well as the force. Now, why it means a small force exerted on a very small area can create a very large pressure, while even a large force when acts on a large area exert a less pressure. For example, if we are walking on a snow, so in a snow, generally we wear the flat shoes. Why? Why don't we wear the normal shoes which has spikes? Because we cannot wear the spike shoes on a snow, as the snow is very soft, and when our force is applied on the basis of the weight, the shoes with the snow, and we are not able to walk on that snow. But if we are using the flat shoes which have the large area, then pressure will be less in that case. And if we are wearing the normal shoes, then area is less, so pressure will be more. And if area pressure increase, then we may go inside the snow. Our leg will go inside the snow and we are not able to walk. So this explains, when we apply a small force on the pointed side of the nail, it comes out as a large pressure on the nail and it gets embedded into the wall. Hence, the pressure depends on number one, force applied, number two, the area over which the force is spread out. So this is the number one and this will be the number two factors. So what are the factors on which pressure depends? The force applied, and number two, the area over which the force is spread out. So SI unit of pressure will be Pascal, PA. And you know from whom we get the Pascal? Pascal has been named in the honor of Blaise Pascal. Pascal was the French scientist. So on the honor of him, the pressure of the unit of pressure has been named as Pascal or PA. So it is defined as 1 Pascal, PA is equal to 1 Newton divided meter square. So when a force of 1 Newton acts on an area of 1 meter square, the pressure exerted is 1 Pascal. So for larger, we have pressure kilopascal. So 1 kilopascal is equal to 1000 Pascals. So underline this line. And also please circle this line so you have to remember it. 1 kilopascal is 1000 pascal. So you can find the pressure exerted by a can of an aerated drink exerting a force of 3.5 newton, and the base, that is the area, 5 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter square. So meter square is the area, the unit of area. 10 to the power minus 3 means 1 divided 1000. So by using the formula, we will write pressure is equal to force / area. So we will get P is equal to 3.5 divided 5 into 10 to the power minus 3. So what we will do? We will just divided 3.5 divided 5 into 10 to the power minus 3. So minus 3, that is, it will go up. 10 to the power minus 3, that means 10 to the power minus 3 means 30. So we say it as 1/, how many 0? 1, 2, 3. So answer will be 3.5 into 1000 divided 5. So put 10 here and then cut it, and 7. So answer will be is equal to 7 Pa. So 7 into 100 is equal to 700 Pascal. So in this way we can calculate. Now what are the application of pressure in daily life? Pressure is very helpful in our daily life also. We know that the tip of sieving needle is sharp. So since pressure is inversely proportional to, area of contact. So pressure is inversely, P is inversely proportional. We say just like this, inversely proportional to A. So a sock puts the large pressure on a very small area of cloth and makes the stitching easy and fast. The tires of bigger vehicles such as buses and trucks have broad and double wheels. This reduces the pressure on the tires and they do not burst. We know that the wider the area of contact, the less is the pressure. And so they can transport greater weight. And what about the tankers? The tankers are used where? In the border area. The tankers are very, very heavy. But have you seen the tanker? They have the bottom, they have the larger area contact. So that larger area contact, what they do? They reduces the pressure. So that's why the tankers are able to walk, to run in the border area. Now, what happened when you use the school bags? The straps of school bags are made thick and wide so as to distribute the heavy weight of large number of books. More the weight, the lesser the amount of weight you feel. So for the same reason, workers carrying heavy loads keep a round cloth on their head. See here, as it spread the load over, so workers are keeping their piece of cloth to increase the area of contact. So if area of contact is more, then pressure will be less. So that's why the workers feel less weight of the bricks or whatever they keep on their head. So this reduces the pressure on the head. So foundation of high-rise buildings are made wider so that the weight of the buildings produce less pressure on the ground and the buildings should not sink into the ground. And do you know, camel is known as the ship of the desert. So it is difficult for us to walk on sand, but a camel, though much heavier, can easily run on sand. So this is because a camel has broad feet, so the weight of the camel spreads over a large area. Thus, the pressure exerted by its body on the sand is much less as compared to the pressure exerted by us. So that's all for today. So read the pages and write the notes. So is it clear that pressure is inversely proportional to area and pressure is directly proportional to force? More area, less pressure. Less area, more pressure. That's all for today.